One of the biggest things that Google has been missing in 2020 and in years past is a real focus on hardware. And in 2021, the Google Home Suite and the Google Suite of products is about to expand seriously, and you're about to reap the benefits. Hello, automators. Welcome to 2021 and our first predictions video. Now, I always love doing these, but sadly, last year I couldn't predict a pandemic taking over and really changing how things went. But this year, things are pretty clear based on just a few things that Google's CEO said in a recent earnings call. What was said by Google's CEO was that they had been spending heavily in hardware for about 3 years, and that lines up with a couple other things we've seen that I'll talk about. But he said, essentially, all of this hardware investment is going to come to fruition in 2021, and we're going to see a ton of output from Google on that front. And this has been one of the major hangups because Google has incredible software teams, and I mean, the whole world uses Google to search, and their incredible teams that have built that system are being deployed and used in other facets of the business now, and this means that you're benefiting from their software expertise. But what hasn't been done yet is that acceleration in terms of hardware. So we always have these great phones, and that's the best example, I think, from Google that are based on Android as an operating system and a ton of software expertise. And you think about the Pixels and their incredible photography capability, well, a lot of that is based on software. And so that brings me to my first prediction here for you in the Google hardware side. And we are seeing more and more rumblings of a Pixel 5 Pro. And I'm not sure that that's what the name will be, and I'm not sure of what the hardware will be in this, but there is one component to that photography, or to that camera anyways, that has been a problem since all the way back, I think it's the Pixel 2. Essentially, the camera hardware has been very similar, or at least close enough that it hasn't kept up with the major competitors in terms of the hardware. And this is something that absolutely has to change with the Pixel 5 Pro and the Pixel 6. And I'm guaranteeing that we're going to see hardware improvements on any new phones coming out from Google in 2021. When you look at their lineup of phones, the other thing that you're going to notice is they've been trending more and more to what most people would consider the mid-range or mid to high range in pricing. And the Pixel 4a definitely is in that mid to low mid range, and yet they're still providing that great software. But I think what you're going to see are some upper end options here for us. 5G obviously is going to be there, and I'm expecting improvements in processing power to be available on these upper end devices as well. But on the smart home side, we've actually seen some devices or some systems actually just completely disappear. And you think about the Google Home Max, well, that's now discontinued. You think about the Nest Secure, and that's now discontinued. We've got to see some replacements in 2021. Well, the good news around the Google Home Max is, although it has been discontinued, well, they're not discontinuing support for that. And the Nest Audio was intended as an initial replacement that allowed you to put two or three of these around a living room or a space in your home and then get pretty comparable sound experience. But we're still missing lots of those other connections that were available on that Google Home Max, and the whole point to the Google Home Max, which was home theater. Now, I'm guaranteeing home theater comes to Google Home system in general, and specifically the Nest Audio and a new Google Home Max type of speaker. It won't be called Google Home Max, but we're gonna get a new one of those. From the smart display standpoint, you know what? These are some of the best smart displays out there today. The Nest Hub and the Nest Hub Max. And actually, that Nest Hub Max is 100% the best smart display out there today. I don't care if Amazon's got their screen moving. It's still the best interface, and that is going to be built on in 2021. And no, I'm not talking about a new version of the Nest Hub Max coming out. That smart display has some more life in it, and I would say it's got a few more years that Google could potentially use that. Now, in 2021, we will see an update of the original, what was called the Google Home Hub and is now the Google Nest Hub. We're gonna see a minor improvement on that. I could see the Nest camera getting dropped into that device with a hardware close off, just like the Nest Hub Max. And we are likely to see a processor improvement go into that. Actually, that was something that was designed in a while ago, and we actually saw a filing for a Google Nest Hub, I think a year ago, with a new processor and probably Thread connectivity as well on that device. But there's something that's been missing from all of our homes for about a year and a half to 2 years now, and this was a much loved device that allowed the audio experience to really be fantastic without spending a lot. And how many people, I don't know, that have asked me about the Chromecast audio in the last year or so and when we're gonna get a replacement? Well, I actually think 2021 is the year that we're gonna see that, but this is going to be a different device than what you have today, or the original version, which just had the 3.5 millimeter output option. I think you're going to see a number of other connectivity options. I think Bluetooth will be there. I even wonder about cast capability. Plus, I'm assuming HDMI as an output method and or that 3.5 millimeter output. Now that's 100% just a prediction for me. Again, we haven't seen any filings on these new devices, and that's always a great precursor for us. And one of the filings I saw a while ago was a new Nest thermostat that had Soli on it, and then we had one come out. So this was a really, really interesting device to look at in the FCC filing, but we didn't have any other details. And then out Google comes with a brand new thermostat here in late 2020, and it's kind of a budgetary option versus the original Nest Learning thermostat. We will see new versions of Nest cameras. Plus, we're gonna see a new Nest Hello doorbell for sure. I can't imagine going another year without another version of that. That Nest Learning thermostat will be there as well. And all of these are, number one, going to be ready for the chip technology whenever Google is ready from a software perspective to enable that. But they're also going to be Thread capable. And I think the point around that is to start to get the ability to still create notifications when you're at home and the internet goes down, but your Nest camera sees someone, or your Nest Hello doorbell is at the front there and it sees someone. But if you don't have internet connectivity, well, it could be a while before you get that message. So I think Google is ready to move on more of the localized automation with Thread and chip hardware or connectivity. The other thing I wouldn't be all that surprised about is if a deal is in the works to buy Wyze. And the reason I say that is because I think we're gonna see a drop in the overall price of the Nest cameras and the Nest Hello doorbell. I think those things are kind of pushed out of the market in a lot of cases by companies like Wyze, who can produce so much capability, but you know, sometimes have little issues with their system. And so what I see happening here is the Nest cameras all come down in price. We have $50 to $100 versions, and then you have this opportunity with Wyze to go and fill in that budget option. And Google really did a very similar thing with buying Fitbit here. It's taken longer to get them into the system, but that was one of the big purchases there that gave them both lower and higher end smart watch or fitness options. The Nest Protect needs to be updated and upgraded, and I think right now we have a bit of an issue with that device. I do expect it to come into the Google Home application and be part of the overall Works with Google Assistant program, but I'm wondering if a brand new version needs to be put out there. Now, that has Thread technology on it, and so I think it could actually be brought up to the new chip standard or be utilized in a lot of systems already on its own. But I think we're going to see a new version, and the reason I'm kind of talking about it this way is we're getting this works with Samsung SmartThings integration going on here between the Nest products, so the camera, the thermostat, and the Nest Hello doorbell. Those are all getting integrated with Samsung SmartThings, and we're seeing that works with Google Assistant, works with Samsung SmartThings programs really get moving now. But the Nest Protect didn't come along with that, and that's because it has a whole different API at this point for connectivity that is used for that product. And it was the same thing with the Nest Secure. So those aren't coming along. As all of the Nest products are brought into the Works with Google Assistant program, that means you're getting all of these triggers. And actually, most of them are already there, and I've had this confirmed by a number of people who are already using the Nest API. Now, what's going on there is that you will get the ability to trigger with the different sensors and the different capabilities of your smart home devices from Google. Now, that's a really important component to everybody's smart home at this point, and you're going to see many more of those options come available to you in early to mid 2021. Now, the other thing around this is they have more sensors on them. The Nest thermostats now with Soli technology have the ability to know when you're around them and can actually trigger off of your activity around them. So there's much more capability, and we're going to see more sensors on the cameras and on the devices in general from Nest. But the thing that they haven't replaced yet are the sensors. And those sensors are actually ready. They're pre-designed. They've been designed for a couple of years, and Google is finally going to release them. They're going to be thread capable and therefore ready for chip connectivity as well in some instances. That'll be a some instances sort of thing. But really what's going to come out is a whole new lineup of sensors that will replace the Nest Secure and can go into ADT systems if they want to go that way. So there's a big shift here, and that will be some of the first times you see those triggers in the Google Home application off of sensors. When we're talking about those triggers though, we have to go a little bit deeper, because this is one of the things that I know so many of you are waiting on, but you might be waiting on the wrong thing. And I worry about this when it actually starts to roll out, how frustrated people are gonna get. So I'm gonna prep you a little bit here and hope that you don't get too mad at the messenger. But what Google has said with that Nest API is that they're letting other companies go and create the routines or create the triggers that you can go ahead and use to drive your automation. And these are intended to be pre-created things. So it's not that you're going to lose the ability to use these triggers in the Google Home app. It's just that many of the first ones are going to be pre-created by another company, and then you're just going to be able to enable them, slightly customize them, and go forward. Now, what we have seen with routines here in 2020 is a major redesign has gone on, and that is in preparation for you to be able to trigger lots of things within that. That's what's going on, and to give you many more options for action. So don't worry, big changes are coming, and the interface was the first part of that. And those won't be the only new features you're gonna get in Google Home, because we've seen this application take off. The settings page now has a search bar because it's going to continue to grow, and that's going to be great news for us in the long run. And one of the biggest things I've been waiting for is home theater setups, and the Google Chromecast, that new one, it's my favorite streaming device at this point, and I really want to be able to use these speakers with them. Plus, I want to use that new Google Home Max. Well, you're going to get that. I don't know whether we're going to get up to like a 5.1 or even have a sub option available to us in 2021, but we are going to get that home theater option. That's been confirmed by Google. You're going to have some restrictions on not the speaker, but I think the Chromecast that you're using. I think it's going to be one of the newer ones. Maybe an Ultra is still available to do that. Maybe a third generation. But I think if you go any further back, I don't think you're going to be able to run those home theater systems. Now, the other thing that we're going to see with all of this is a major shift in gaming technology. And I know lots of you weren't that interested in Stadia, maybe you don't play games right now, but what we've seen is the creation of a game lobby on those Nest hubs. And that is really important because it's going to integrate with Stadia in the long run. And we should see that come kind of middle of 2021 onto your Nest hubs with the ability to pair that Stadia controller or the PlayStation or Xbox Bluetooth pairing capability that we have with our phones, and I even have been using on the Google Chromecast. So you're going to see this massive shift into gaming technology from Google, because they're all about YouTube, Stadia, and their services in general. So you're going to see that all come together in a really great way in 2021. And one of the biggest things for the international community has been that you've been lagging in lots of these features. So you're still in some cases missing continued conversations. And again, don't shoot the messenger. I'm just here to tell you what I know. But what I have noticed is cloud hubs being set up and kind of district-based offices being set up to develop those cloud services, manage them, maintain them, and grow them out around the world with a specific focus on Europe and Asia. And this is really important for you to get all of these great Google Assistant features. But here's the biggest thing that's coming from Google in 2021. This is something that's going to change my life, and I think it's going to change the way the world shops in a lot of situations. And this is kind of what we see in the market in general. You know, Amazon's building a gaming service. Well, so is Google. And actually, we're hearing Apple is doing the same thing with the new version of their Apple TV, and they kind of already had a service. But they're all kind of running to the same place. And one of the same places that everyone's running towards is selling devices or selling hardware or selling products. And Amazon right now is kicking everyone to the curb. Google knows this. They know they've got to get in on this, and they've been preparing YouTube to become that centerpiece. And in 2021, I think we're going to see the first starts, the first releases of products being sold on videos just like this. And I think this will absolutely change not only how your smart home works, but how you consume content, what kind of content you consume, and what is the result of that. Are you going to buy something, and how you're going to buy that thing? Because I think you're going to be able to, within a few years, I don't think this is 2021, say you want to buy a product after you've watched it on a Nest Hub or a Nest Hub Max, and Google will be making little bits of money on all those transactions. Now, in a few months, you might want to come back on this video and say, Brian, you sure were wrong on that, and I'm okay with this. These are fun. Some of these predictions come true every year. Some of them just don't, and we have a pandemic instead. Now, what you're going to want to do in order to be able to tell me that in a couple of months is to watch the playlist that's up on screen. And if you just come back to that playlist every week, you're going to see new news in the smart home and automation space. So you're going to see everything from Google and Amazon and Apple and Samsung and all of these big companies that are helping you save time in your life. Otherwise, guys, thanks for watching this video today. And of course, don't hate, automate.